All right, today I'm looking at June 2012 paper 2 A level by Zimsec. So let us check it out. Number one, item one says verify that the equation, this one here, has a root between negative 4 and negative 3. So here you need to rearrange your equation into f of x equals to sine x plus cos x, then negative e to the power x plus 1. Then to check if the root lies between negative 4 and negative 3, we are going to substitute like this: negative 4 equals to sine negative 4 plus cos negative 4 minus e to the power negative 4 plus 1, which is going to give us a value here, which is, I can round off to just 1. Then I'm going to do the same for f of negative 3, which is going to give me sine negative 3 plus cos negative 3 minus e negative 3 plus 1, which is equals to negative 0.2. okay, so what proves to us that the root lies between these two is because of sign change there. So in your conclusion, you're going to write there is sign change. All right, the reason behind why we're saying sign change shows that the root lies between them is like this. We have a Cartesian plane here, we have negative 4 here, negative 3, and our graph is passing here, which means our root is around here, around here. So which means if you put here and then here, your graph is coming here and then your graph is coming here, which means these are your roots here. This root is negative because we are below this line here, then this one is positive. So here you're going to get a positive, here a negative. That's why we are saying if there's sign change, the root lies between them. So let's proceed to item two. Use the Newton-Raphson method to find this root correct to three decimal places. Okay, Newton-Raphson method, the formula says xn plus 1 equals to xn minus f of x n over f, which is first derivative xn. So first we need to find the first derivative. Let's differentiate that one. We're going to get f prime equals to cos x, because it's this one here. Sine is going to give us cos, cos negative sine, then e will remain as it is. So coming here, I have cos x minus sine x minus e to the power of x. Okay, then now we are plugging into our Newton-Raphson. So I'm going to say my x1 equals to, you can choose any value there, whether it's negative 3 or negative 4 for your x1, but I'm going to choose negative 4 as my x1. Okay, then now I come here and say x2 equals to minus 4 minus, so I'm implementing this formula here now, I'm putting into the formula. So minus 4 there, then here it's a cos negative 4 plus a sine negative 4 minus e to the power negative 4 plus 1. Then below here is cos negative 4 minus sine negative 4 minus e to the power negative 4. Then on a calculator, that is going to give me negative 3.2407. This value here is negative 2, which is in between these two, which means it is around here. So I'm going to take that value and then put it again in the formula. Now this one is now being put in place of negative 4, and then if I do that, I'll find my x3 is equal to negative 3.182. Then again, I'm going to get negative 3.1823. Then again, I'm going to get negative 3.1822. So here I'm getting something common here. This 2 is repeating here, here, and here. So which means I can conclude that my x equals to negative 3.182. So this is our answer there for number 1. And we are going to write here to 3dp. Okay. Then moving on to number 2. So number 2 is supposed to prove by mathematical induction. This one here. So I need to prove that one by induction. So by induction, first you say when n equals to 1, then you put your n for r there, which is going to be 1 plus 3 times a 2 plus 1, which is going to give us 12, equals to this side. We're going to have 1 over 6, 4 plus 27 plus 41, which is also going to give us 12. Then you conclude that therefore true for n equals to 1. Then now you assume true for n equals to k. Then you just write the statement here. We have k there, r equals to 1. Then here you've got r plus 3, 2r plus 1 equals to k over 6, 4k squared plus 27k plus 41. Right, after that you then say when n equals to k plus 1, then you write this it here as k plus 1 r equals to 1. Then you've got the same thing, which was r plus 3 2r plus 1. Okay, then you say equal. I'm not going to write here because what I want to write is too long, so I'm going to start here, but it's supposed to be here. So here I have what k r equals to 1, then r plus 3 2r plus 1 plus k plus 1 plus 3, then times 2k plus 1 plus 1. So what we're basically saying is that this one here is same as this one up to k, then plus this one, and in place of r was substituting k plus 1. So that's what that statement means. So now I need to replace this one here with the k over 6, 4k squared plus 27k plus 41. Then plus, I need to simplify this side, and I'm going to get k plus 4 from this one here. In terms, this one I'm going to get 2k plus 3. All right, this is what I have now. So what I need to do is expand this one here into 2k squared plus 11k plus 12. Then this one I'm going to put it as it is. So it's k over 6, 4k squared plus 27k plus 41. Right, now I'm supposed to mix these things here, so I'm going to take my 1 over 6 as a common factor there, and here I'm going to remain with what this k now is, now multiplying everything inside there. So I'm going to get 4k cubed plus 27k squared plus 41k, like this. Then this side, now I need to remove 1 over 6 from each and every one of them to get a plus a 12k squared plus a 66k plus 72. So what I'm just doing there, I'm simply taking this one from this one. So if I multiply this one and this one, they're going to give me 2k. Then this one times this one, I'm going to get 11k. So this is what we just did there. Then now we need to simplify that one. We have 1 over 6. Then simplifying there, we've got 4k cubed plus 39k squared plus 10, 7k plus 7, 2. Okay, so this is what we have. Now we need to factorize that cubic function. So I'm going to use try and error to find a root, and if I call it f of x, or rather f of k, equals to 4k cubed plus 39k squared plus 107k plus 72, and then say f negative 1, I'm going to get 0. So which means k plus 1 is a factor there. So I'm going to say k plus 1. Now I'm dividing it, which is 4k cubed plus 39k squared plus 107k plus 72. I need to divide there. So I'm going to get 4k squared, 4k cubed. Then here is going to be plus 4k squared. Subtracting there, I get 35k squared. And then k into that one, I get plus 35k squared plus 35k. Subtracting again, I get 72k. Okay, then dividing there, I get plus 72. Then here I get 72k plus 72. Then separating, I get 0. So which means I now have two factors, which are this one and this one. So coming back here, I now have k plus 1 and 4k squared plus 35k plus 72. Here I've got a 1 over 6, like this. Okay, so I can remove that k plus 1, like this, and remain with the 4k squared plus 35k plus 72. Having this one, I can say, but 4k plus 1 squared plus 27k plus 1 plus 41. This is what I'm trying to achieve by substituting k plus 1. So if I expand that one, I'm going to find that it is equal to 4k squared plus 35k k plus 7 2. This one is this one. That means this one here can be put there. So what I'm going to remain with is k plus 1 over 6, then 4k plus 1 squared plus 27k plus 1 plus 4, 1. So this is what we were expecting to get if we substitute k plus 1 in this one here. So we have done that. So now I need to conclude that therefore true for n equals to k plus 1. Then I write the conclusion. If true for n equals to k, then true for n equals to k plus 1. Then since true for n equals to 1, therefore true for n equals to 2, 3, and so on. Therefore true for n is an element of real numbers, positive real numbers. So this is it's all about your induction. So this is what is supposed to give you 7 marks. Now we are on number 3, and it says an isosceles triangle with a constant perimeter of 2k is such that the equal sides are of each length x. Find in terms of x and k the expression for the length of the base of the triangle. So we have a triangle here. These are equal and are x. Perimeter equals to 2k here. So this is a base. So base for item 1 equals to 2k minus 2x. So I can simplify into 2k minus x. Then item 2, I'm supposed to find the perpendicular height of the triangle. So this is the perpendicular height here. And by Pythagoras theory, let me call it h. H squared equals to x squared minus half of b squared, which is equal to x squared. Half of b there is minus a k minus x squared. Then I'm going to expand that one and simplify. It's going to give me x squared minus k squared minus 2kx plus x squared, like this. Okay, so I'm going to simplify that one, and I'm going to get x squared minus k squared plus 2kx minus x squared, which is equals to 2kx minus k squared equals to our h squared. So our h equals to square root of 2kx minus k squared. So this is our answer for h. Then b, by first writing the expression for the area a of the triangle in terms of x and k, show that the stationary value of the area occurs when x is equal to 2 over 3k. Okay, so let's find the area there. B, area equals to half this times height, which equals half 2kx minus k squared k minus x. Okay, so this will cancel. We're going to get k minus x square root of 2kx minus k squared. This is our a. We need to find the stationary value, so we need to differentiate. So dA over dx equals to what? A negative root of 2kx minus k squared plus k minus x times k over, square root of 2kx plus no, it's minus k squared. Okay, so at stationary point, dy over dx, or in this case dA over dx, will be zero. So what we end up having is k squared minus k x, I'm expanding this one here, over square root of 2k x minus k squared minus square root of 2k x minus k squared equals to zero. Now we need to simplify that one. Common denominator is a square root of 2k x minus k squared. Then here I'm going to get a k squared minus k x minus 2 k x plus k squared equals to zero. So I've got k squared minus k x minus 2 k x plus k squared equals to zero. Then simplifying there, I've got 2k squared minus 3kx equals to zero, and I've got 3kx equals to 2k squared. Dividing by 3k, I've got x equals to 2 over 3k. So we have shown here that our stationary point is at here. Number 4 says Mr. Kumar bought a car at $4,000. A statistical model pertaining to the depreciation assumes that the value V dollars of the car T month after it has been bought decreases at a rate which is proportional to V. Then item 1, using this model, write a differential equation connecting V and T and show that it reduces to V equals to 4000 e to the power negative kt, where k is a positive constant. So depreciation is dv over dt, and it is a negative here because the value is decreasing, and they are saying that it is proportional to V. Now I need to solve this one as a differential equation. So I can say negative dv over dt equals to kv. Okay, so dv over dt equals to negative kv. Then rearranging there, I've got dv over v equals to negative k dt. Then I apply the integral sign both sides. Then this side I've got a ln v equals to negative kt plus c. Then we are told that at t equals to zero, this is when the car was bought, the value was 4000 because it was bought with 4000. So I can substitute there to find my c, which is going to be ln 4000 equals to c, right? So my c is equals to ln 4000. Now I can go back to my original equation and substitute, which is going to be ln v equals to negative kt plus ln 4000. Now I can apply e both sides, and if I apply e to this one, I will remain with v. So it's going to be v equals to e to the power negative kt plus ln 4000. We have got e to the power negative kt times e to the power ln 4000, and e to the power ln implies that our answer is this number here, just like we did with this one here. So now we are going to get v equals to 4000 e to the power negative kt. So it is shown. This is what we're trying to show according to our question here. Here we have shown that it reduces to that one. Then item two, it is further given that after 3 years, the car is valued at 2000. Calculate the value of the car when it is 15 months old, giving your answer to the nearest $8. Okay, we are told that after 3 years, the value is 2000. So 3 years equals to 12 times 3, which is equals to 36 months. Okay, so which means 2000 was equals to 4000 e to the power negative k. Our t is 36, so I can divide both sides by 4000 and I'm going to get a 1 over 2 equals to e to the power negative k 36. So I can apply ln and I'm going to get ln half equals to negative k 36. Okay, so this ln half, by laws of logs, I can have ln 1 minus ln 2, of which ln 1 is 0, so I'm going to get negative ln 2 equals to negative k 36. Then I know that my k equals to 1 over 36 ln 2. Then I can substitute this one and have v equals to 4000 e to the power negative 1 over 36 ln 2 times our t, that I can just put here like this. Then now I need to calculate the value when it is 15 month old. So what is the value there? Value equals to 4000 e to the power negative 15 over 36 ln 2. Then plugging that to my calculator, I get v equals to $2,997. So this is the answer there. Then moving on to B, the age of the car when it is valued at 1.6, giving your answer to the nearest month. Okay, so now I'm looking at my t given the value. Then B, I've got v equals to 4000 e to the power negative t over 36 ln 2, and I'm told that we want the time when value is 1600 equals to 4000 e to the power negative t over 36 ln 2. So I've got ln 1600 over 4000 equals to negative t over 36 ln 2. So my t equals to 36 ln 16 over 40 over ln 2, which is going to give me 48 month. So this is my time there. So we're through with number 4. Number 5a, the vector equations of the lines L1 and L2 are given there, respectively. Find the coordinates of the point of intersection of the lines L1 and L2. So intersection of two lines, we have our line 1, and I'm going to rewrite the equation as R equals to 2 plus lambda minus 3 plus 2 lambda 1 plus 2 lambda. R equals to 8 plus 3 mu, 5 plus 2 mu, 13 plus 6 mu, like this. So to find the point of intersection, you just equate these ones and then solve. I've got 2 plus lambda equals to 8 plus 3 mu. I've got negative 3 plus 2 lambda equals to 5 plus 2 mu. Okay, this is my equation 2. Then I have to solve that one. I will say equation 3 lambda equals to 6 plus 3 mu. I'm rearranging equation 1 there to get equation 3. Then I substitute minus 3 plus 2, 6 plus 3 mu equals to 5 plus 2 mu. So negative 3 plus 12 plus 6 mu equals to 5 plus 2 mu. So 4 mu equals to negative 4. So mu equals to negative 1. Then substituting to equation 3, I've got lambda equals to 6 plus 3 negative 1, which gives lambda as a 3. Then to find our point of intersection, I'm simply substituting either lambda or mu to this on top. So I'm going to choose to substitute lambda. So I'm going to get 2 plus 3, negative 3 plus 2, 3, 1 plus 2, 3, which is going to give us a 5, 3, 7 as our point of intersection. Then next we have B. The plane pi is given by 2x minus z equals to 3. Verify that lines L1 and L2 both lie in the plane. So B, we've got our plane here that I'm going to rewrite into R dot 20 negative 1 equals to 3. So to verify that a line lies in a plane, I just put the line here. So I've got 2 plus lambda minus 3 plus 2 lambda 1 plus 2 lambda, like this. Then I multiply the 20 negative 1 equals to 3. I need to prove that this is true. So I've got 4 plus 2 lambda minus 1 minus 2 lambda equals to 3. So this side is 3 equals to 3. Therefore L1 lies in pi. Then now doing L2, I've got 8 plus 3 mu, 5 plus 2 mu, then 3 plus 6 mu, then 20 negative 1 equals to 3. Then I'm going to get 16 plus 6 mu minus 13 minus 6 mu equals to 3. So here I've got 3 equals to 3. Therefore, L2 lies in pi. So I'm done with number B. Moving to C. It is given that the position vector of the point A is this one here, and B is the foot of the perpendicular from A to pi. Find the vector equation of AB. So I need the vector equation of line AB. So the scenario that we have here, we've got pi here, which is a plane. Then we have our A here. Our B is the foot here. So our plane has a normal which is perpendicular to plane. So to form the equation of a line that is perpendicular to a plane, you use the normal of that plane. So our R equals to, just take the position vector on the line, which is this one here, 12 5 6. So it's a 12 5 6 plus a parameter which I'm going to use lambda, then I put the normal of that plane, which is 2, 0, -1. So this is the answer there. Then hence find the position vector of B. Okay, so I need the point of intersection of the line AB and the plane pi. So I will come here and do that. It is a C item 2. So I've got my line, which is a line AB, which is equal to 12 plus 2 lambda 5 6 minus lambda. So I'm putting this one there as 12 plus 2 lambda 5 6 minus lambda. I need to find the point of intersection 0, -1 equals to 3. Right now I need to simplify that one. So I've got a 24 plus 4 lambda minus 6 plus lambda equals to 3. Then my lambda equals to -3. Having that lambda, I can substitute to find my B in the line here on top. So I'm going to get my B equals to 12 plus -3, 2, 5, 6 minus -3. This is going to give me 6, 5, 9 as my point of intersection. So this is all about our number 5. Then number 6a, it is given that the complex number A whose conjugate is A bar satisfies the equation 4a A bar plus 12i equals to 8a plus 16. Find the two possible values of A, giving your answer in form P plus IQ, where P and Q are real. So I'm given this one. I need to find A. Okay, so what I can do is reassign value to A as X plus YI. I've got 4A A bar plus 12I equals to 8A plus 16. So I can divide by 4 everything there and get A bar plus 3i equals to 2a plus 4. Then let A equals to x plus yi. So which means here I've got x plus yi, x minus yi plus 3i equals to 2x plus yi plus 4. Then expanding there, I've got x squared plus y squared plus 3i equals to 2x plus 2yi plus 4. Then equating the real parts and the imaginary parts. So imaginary parts, I've got this side is 3i equals to 2yi. So which means my y equals to 3 over 2. Okay, then now I need to find my x. I'm going to equate the real parts, which are these ones that do not have I. So I'm going to get what? X squared plus y squared equals to 2x plus 4. I already know the value of y, which is 3 over 2. So I've got x squared plus 3 over 2 squared equals to 2x plus 4. X squared plus 9 over 4 equals to 2x plus 4. Then multiplying everything by 4, I've got 4x squared plus 9 equals to 8x plus 16. Then moving to one side, I've got 4x squared minus 8x minus 7 equals to 0. Then solving by quadratic formula, which says x equals to negative b plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a, and substituting there, so I've got 8 plus or minus square root of 64 minus 4 times 4 times negative 7, which is going to make it plus here over 2 times 4, which is going to give us a 8. So here we've got 8 plus or minus square root of 176 over 8. So this is equals to 8 plus square root of 176 over 8, or 8 minus square root of 176 over 8. So my x equals to 2.66 or negative 0.66 to 2 dp, which means my a is now going to be 2.66 minus 1.5i. this 1.5i is our y, which we said it is a 3 over 2. 3 over 2 is 1.5, so my a is going to be this one, or negative 0.66 plus, here I've got plus also, so plus 1.5i. so these are two values of a. Then moving on to b, the polynomial, this one is denoted by p of x. Show that 3i is a root of this polynomial. Okay, so it's simple, there I just substitute that 3i for x and see if it gives me 0. So if I say p of x equals to 2x to the power 4 plus x cubed plus 17x squared plus 9x minus 9, and then say p of that 3i equals to 0, then therefore 3i is a root. Then what is the next one? The next one, item 2, state the other complex root, which is negative 3i. Complex roots exist as conjugates, so the conjugate of this one is just this one. Then item 3, hence or otherwise find the other two roots of the equation. Okay, so now we come here. This was b, item 1. Then item 2, we said it's negative 3i. Then item 3, you are supposed to solve it. So to solve it, I'm going to say x minus 3i, x plus 3i. So I'm going to use these two roots to come up with a quadratic that I'm going to use to divide that that p of x. So here I'm going to get x squared plus 9 as my answer. Now I've got x squared plus 9 dividing our p of x, which is 2x to the power 4 plus x cubed plus 17x plus 9x minus 9. So dividing there, I've got 2x squared, 2x to the power of 4, then plus 18x squared. Here I've squared also. Then I subtract, I got x cubed minus x squared. Then again I've got plus x, x cubed plus 9x. Subtracting again, I've got minus x squared. Then x squared into there, I've got negative 1. Negative x squared minus 9, then I've got 0 there, so I've got 2 here. This one and this one. I already know the solution for this one. Now I need the solution for this one here. So I'm going to solve it directly. So I've got 2x squared plus x minus 1 equals to 0. Then here I've got 2x squared plus 2x minus x minus 1 equals to 0. 2x x plus 1 x plus 1 negative 1. Then 2x minus 1 x plus 1 equals to 0. So my x equals to negative 1 or half. So these are the other two roots. Number 7a, this transformation matrix given there maps the line y onto line this one. Find the equation of the line y giving your answer in form ax plus by equals to c, where a, b and c are integers. So here I've got my x prime, y prime being equal to negative 2, 1, 3, 2. Then times x, y. Then I'm going to multiply there and I'm going to get negative 2x plus y and 3x plus 2y. So in other words, this is like this, and my x prime and y prime are like this. So in other words, I'm having my y prime equals to 3x plus 2y. Okay, but I'm also told also that my y prime equals to 6x plus 8. So I'm going to equate those. 6x plus 8 equals to 3x plus 2y. Then rearranging that one, I get 2y minus 3x equals to 8. So this is my equation in this form. Then I can move on to B. Given M and N, find Mn. So I'm just multiplying there. So it's B, item 1, Mn, 3, 2, 1, minus 2, 2, 0, 1, 0, 0. Multiplying 0, 1, 3, 1, 4, negative 2, 1, 0, 2. Then doing my row by column multiplication, I get 3, 11, 7, 2, 6, minus 10, 0, 1, 3. So this is our answer there. Then moving on to item 2, which says find the inverse of that answer. So I need to start by finding the determinant, which is going to be 3 6 3 minus 10 1. So the way you are getting this one, you cover your 3 like this, then you take this box here, okay? Then you say minus 11, then for 11 you cover 11 there, then you take these ones and these ones. So here I've got 2 minus 10, 0, 8. Then I'm going to do the same thing for the last one here, which is the 7. 7 takes this box. So it's going to be plus 2, 6, 0, 1. So what we are doing here is we are saying 6 times 3, then minus negative 10 times 1, which is going to give us a 28. Then we do the same procedure for all these ones. Then we get negative 11, 6 plus 7, 2. Then our answer becomes 32. So this is our determinant. Having a determinant, we need to create a matrix that is made up of cofactors of each and every one of these here. So a cofactor is a box like this that is not in line with our value in any way. So the cofactor of this one will be these ones because they are not in line. Then the cofactor of this one, the 7e, are these ones. They are not in line with 7 in any way. Then the cofactor of this 6 here is going to be this one, this one, this one, and this one, because they are not in line with our 6. That's how you find cofactors. So let's create the matrix made out of cofactors. So we've got Mn with our matrix that I can call matrix T equals to a giant matrix like this. So here I've got the first cofactor of 3 there. It's a 6 minus 10, 1, 3, minus 2 minus 10, 0, 3. Then next is 2, 6, 0, 1. Next is minus 11, 7, 1, 3. Then next 3, 7, 0, 3. Next, it is negative outside, 3, 11, 0, 1. Then next is 11, 7, 6, negative 10. Next, it is a negative there. So it's 3, 7, 2, minus 10. Then here we've got 3, 11, 2, and 6. Then for each and every one of those cofactors, you find the determinant and you're going to get the results here as 28 minus 6, 2 minus 26, 9 minus 3 minus 1, 5, 2, 4, 4, and negative 4. Okay, so this is our M. N T. Now we now transpose this one to get our adjoint M N. This is a matrix where you interchange the rows and columns of this transpose here. So let's transpose it. We are going to get, for example, here the first one is, I'm going to turn this one into a column. So it's a 28 minus 6. 2. Then the next one is negative 26, 9, negative 3. Then the next one is negative 1, 5, 2, 4, 4, minus 4. Okay. Then our inverse now, M, N, power negative 1, is just 1 over determinant terms. This adjoint matrix. So we've got 28 minus 26 minus 1, 5, 2 minus 6, 9, 4, 4, 2 minus 3 minus 4. This is our inverse there. Then next, hence find the values of x, y, and z for which Mn times this one equal to that one. So what they are simply saying is that multiply with Mn to the power negative 1 to this side and to that size. The reason why you are multiplying with that one is that A times A negative 1 is going to give us an identity, which is same as 1 in matrix terms. So if you're multiplying with inverse there, we are going to remain with 1 here. So this will be gone here, remain with the XYZ equals to whatever is the side. So in this side, we are simply multiplying this one with the same thing that we used this side. So let us do that. So we are saying that our XYZ equals to multiplication with an inverse. So our inverse here, we left it with that 1 over the 2 outside. But if I'm going to use it to multiply, I'm going to multiply each and every a component of it with this 1 over the 2. So I'm going to get 28 over 32 minus 26 over 32 minus 152 over 32 minus 6 over 32 9 over 32 4 over 32 2 over 32 minus 3 over 32 minus 4 over 32. Then I multiply this side here. I'm multiplying this side with the inverse. So it's what here? It's 3 minus 6 and 3. I multiply there and I'm getting my answer is minus 27 over 4. 15 over 8 and 3 over 8. So this is equal to x, y, and z. Okay. So this is my answer. My x equals to negative 27 over 4. My y equals to 15 over 8. And my z equals to 3 over 8. So this is the answer there. So this is all about this paper on the pure maths part.